B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. I want you to think back to our lesson on physical and chemical changes. Do you remember what a chemical change is? A chemical change is when one substance changes and becomes a new, different substance. In this unit, we are going to learn about the reactions that cause these chemical changes. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to define a chemical reaction, define reactants and products, apply the law of conservation of mass when balancing chemical equations. A chemical reaction is when two or more substances react to form new substances. For example, magnesium and oxygen react to form magnesium oxide. However, sometimes a chemical reaction is more involved and includes a lot of different substances. To make chemical reactions more user-friendly, chemists use chemical equations. A chemical equation is a symbolic representation of chemical reactions. In a chemical equation, the chemical formula for each reacting substance, or reactant, is written, followed by the substance that is produced, or product, in the reaction. The standard format for a chemical equation is to write the reactants on the left, connected by addition signs, then an arrow pointing from left to right, followed by the products connected by addition signs. When reading a chemical equation, you use the word yield for the arrow. For example, magnesium plus oxygen yields magnesium oxide. All chemical reactions must follow the law of conservation of mass. This law states that mass is neither created or destroyed in a chemical reaction. What this means is that every atom present in the reactants must also be present in the products. For example, in the chemical equation 2H2 plus O2 yields 2H2O, you have 4 hydrogen atoms and 2 oxygen atoms in the reactants and products. Let's look at the reaction between magnesium and oxygen one more time. How many atoms of magnesium are in the reactants? There is 1 magnesium atom. How about oxygen? There are 2 atoms of oxygen. Now, let's take a look at the products. There is 1 atom of magnesium and 1 atom of oxygen in the products. Does this chemical equation follow the law of conservation of mass? No. Somehow we lost an atom of oxygen along the way. Do you have any idea how we can fix this? Well, what happens if the equation looks like this instead? By adding a 2 in front of the magnesium, we are saying that we would be adding 2 magnesium atoms to the reaction. The 2 in front of the MgO means we have 2 magnesium oxide compounds, so each atom in the formula is multiplied by 2. Which means we have 2 magnesium atoms and 2 oxygen atoms. This means that we have 2 magnesium atoms and 2 oxygen atoms in our reactants and 2 magnesium oxide compounds, which gives us 2 magnesium atoms and 2 oxygen atoms in our products. Now our reaction meets the law of conservation of mass. This is called a balanced equation. This process of making sure that a chemical equation meets the law of conservation of mass is called balancing chemical equations. To balance a chemical equation, you can follow these steps. First, make a list of all of the atoms that are present in the reactants and the products. Next, look at the atoms of each element to see if you can add a coefficient or a large number in front of the chemical formulas to balance the number of atoms of each element. When you add a coefficient to each compound, update the list of elements in that compound. One important rule when balancing equations is that you can only add coefficients in front of compounds. You cannot change the formula of a compound by changing the subscript. This is because if you change the subscript, you change the compound. For example, 2O2 means two oxygen molecules, while O4 is not a molecule. Once your reactants list matches your products list, your equation is balanced. Let's work through these steps to balance the equation. N2 plus H2 yields NH3. Let's make a list of the number of atoms of each element in the reactants and products. In our reactants, we have two nitrogen atoms and two hydrogen atoms. In our products, we have one nitrogen atom and three hydrogen atoms. Let's try to balance our nitrogen atoms first. We have two in our reactants and just one in our products. We can place a 2 in front of NH3 in the products. Let's update our list. By placing a 2 in front of the molecule, we now have two of those molecules. This means we have two nitrogen atoms, one in each molecule, and six hydrogen atoms, three in each molecule. Our nitrogen atoms match, but what about our hydrogen atoms? Oh no, now they don't match. Any ideas of what we can do? We can place a 3 in front of the H2 in the reactants. By placing a 3 there, we have 3 of those molecules, giving us a total of 6 hydrogen atoms in our reactants to match our 6 hydrogen atoms in the products. Let's update our list. Wow! Look at that! Our equation is balanced. Okay, I think you're ready to try one on your own. Try to balance the chemical equation Li plus AlCl3 yields LiCl plus Al. Remember, make a list and update it every time you add a coefficient. When your reactant list matches your product list, the equation is balanced. Pause the video and give it a try. Welcome back! Check your answer against mine. How did you do? If balancing equations is still a little confusing, don't worry. You will have some more practice in the lesson PDF. And our next lesson is a PHET simulation on balancing equations. Both of these are great opportunities to continue practicing this concept. As we went through the lesson today, we learned how the law of conservation of mass applies to chemical reactions, and then practiced balancing chemical equations. In our next lesson, you will continue practicing this concept while working through a PHET simulation. Until next time, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. See you next time. Hey, hey.